Hello everyone, this is Ashi Soni and I am preparing some videos which will cover the topics which are mainly asked in medical entrance examination. You can also refer my videos for your 12th board purpose. My first topic is metallurgy. In this video you will see that what are the basic steps involved in metallurgy and then extraction of certain elements. This chapter or this video is basically a summary of metallurgy. I will recommend all of you to read NCERT after watching this video, and this video will clear your concept and make this chapter way more easier than before. So now let's get started. First of all, metallurgy basically involves separation of metal. Now, separation of metal which we get in form of ore from earth. The first method for extraction of metals is its concentration. Second method is isolation from concentrated ore. We have concentrated ore which we got from earth. After that, we have concentrated. Now the last and final process is purification or refining. After that we refine our ore. Now for concentration there are basically two methods. First method is physical method and second one is chemical method. Now in physical method we can concentrate ore simply by hand picking, that is the unwanted materials are thrown out using our hand. Second is gravity separation. Gravity separation involves separation of or concentration of ore on the basis of mass. The higher metal settle down and the low and the one which with light weight will float. Third and fourth process. These both processes are very important for your entrance examination. Now third one is magnetic separation and fourth one is fourth flotation method. Magnetic separation is used for separating the compounds which have magnetic properties or which are attracted towards magnet. Fourth one is fourth flotation. Fourth flotation is mainly used for ores containing sulfur, such as copper sulfate. Now physical methods has been finished. Let's come to the chemical methods. Chemical method involve leaching, and there are two different processes used for different metals. First one is for aluminium, we use Bayer's process, which is basically what leaching. Now the second one is MacArthur process, which is used for concentration of gold and silver. These both points are given very nicely in NCERT, so do read NCERT after watching this video. Now as we have concentrated our ore, we need to isolate. For isolation we need to convert it into oxide and then we will reduce and get free metal. Okay, first process is conversion into oxide and second one is reduction to free metal. Okay, now calcination. Now to convert metal into its oxide we just heat it. Now for heating there are two processes, calcination and roasting. Calcination is heating of ore in absence of air and roasting is heating of ore in supply of air. This is a very important difference between calcination and roasting. Now as we have converted our metal into its oxide, we need to reduce it to get free metal. Now reduction can be done by heating or chemical processes and electrochemical reduction. Electrochemical reduction basically involves use of electrolysis, and this process is used for aluminium and it is named as Hall-Herold process. The process for reduction of aluminium is called Hall-Heroult process. Okay, now second process or third process, free metal. Reduction to free metal can also be done by smelting. Reduction at high temperature. This is smelting is generally reduction at high temperature. This can be done by carbon or in presence of carbon as well as by aluminium. When we use aluminium for smelting, this is called thermite process. Or it is also known as gold schmidt aluminothermic process. Smelting can also be done by self-reduction, electrolytic reduction, hydrometallurgy and amalgamation. In amalgamation, mainly mercury is used. Now, we have concentrated our ore, we have isolated. Now, the last process involves refining. Refining can be done by distillation, liquation, distillation. Distillation mainly is of different types like fractional distillation, etc. Second is liquation. Third one is electrolytic refining. Electrolytic refining also use electrodes and electrolysis. Electrolytic refining is used for separation or refining of copper, silver and lead. For silver, it is used, the process which is used is called Möbius process, and for lead it is used Betts process. Now there is a trick for learning this, SM. SM, silver, and for silver the process is Möbius process, and for lead it is Betts process, LB. SM and LB. Next one is zone refining. Fifth process for refining purpose is vapor phase refining. Vapor phase refining for nickel is Mohn's process, and for zirconium is von Arkel method. For nickel, Mohn's process, and zirconium, von Arkel method. Chromatographic methods are also used for refining. Now, as we have done the basic concept of metallurgy, that is concentration, isolation and purification. Now, we will read about certain specific elements. First metal is aluminium. Now, aluminium is found mainly in two types of ores. First, the very important ore of aluminium is bauxite, and the second one is cryolite. Bauxite is an oxide of aluminium, and cryolite is sodium aluminium fluorine metal or ore. Now, for concentration of aluminium, we already read that Baer's process is used, and that is a method of leaching. This is used for red bauxite. Baer's process is used for red bauxite. Now, in this process, bauxite is heated in presence of sodium hydroxide, and then we get sodium aluminium oxide and water. This is very important that water is released in this process. Second process is Sperk's process for white bauxite. Now there are two different processes. First one is Baer's process and second is Sperk's process. Baer's process is used for concentration of red bauxite, and Sperk's process is used for concentration of white bauxite. Now as we are done with concentration, the next process is reduction or concentration. For concentration, we need to convert it into oxide and then reduce. As here is oxide, so now we directly reduce it. For reduction, electrolytic reduction is used, and it is called Hall-Heroult process. In this process, Al2O3 is dissolved in Na3AlF6 as it is electrolytic reduction. The oxide has to be dissolved in certain electrolyte, and the electrolyte used is Na3AlF6. Now the last process is refining. Electrolytic refining is used, and the process is named as Hoops process. So first, what we have read, that concentration, Bayes process, and Sparks process. Reduction is done by electrolytic process, and Hall-Herold process it is known as. Now it in this Al2O3 is dissolved in Na3AlF6. After that refining, for refining, electrolytic refining is used, and the process is called Hoops process. Our next metal is iron. Now first of all, different ores of iron include hematite, magnetite, siderite, and iron pyrites. These are four important ores of iron which are given in NCERT. Now purity, as there are four types of iron found, three types of iron found: wrought iron, pig iron, and cast iron. Wrought iron, pig iron, and cast iron. The purity of wrought iron is the greatest. After that pig iron, and then cast iron. As the purity decreases, carbon content in iron increases. So the less carbon, wrought iron has less carbon content as compared to pig iron and cast iron. Now for isolation, extraction of iron, there are same three processes: concentration, purification, and then isolation, and then purification. Concentration, isolation, and then purification. For concentration, mainly magnetic separation is used because it has magnetic properties. So iron can be concentrated by magnetic separation. After magnetic separation, we do isolation. In isolation, we all know that there are two processes. First is conversion into oxide, and second one is reduction. The very first process of isolation is calcination. Calcination means heating in absence of oxygen, heating in absence of air. Now, for in calcination, moisture is removed, impurities are removed, and iron oxide, ferrous oxide is oxidized into ferric oxide. After that, smelting is done. In smelting process, ore is treated with CaCO3 and coke. Now there are different zones for smelting. First one is combustion zone, fusion zone, reduction zone, and slag formation zone. The smelting is done in presence of CaCO3 and coke. There are four different zones in smelting process. First one is combustion zone. It is the lowermost zone. It is the lowermost zone, and the temperature is around 1800 Kelvin. Combustion zone is this lowermost zone, and temperature is around 1800 Kelvin. The next zone is fusion zone. In this combustion zone, the carbon is, or the coke is, oxidized into carbon dioxide. Next zone is fusion zone. In fusion zone, the CO2 which is formed in combustion zone rises up and react with coke again. This CO2 will react with coke again, and it will form carbon monoxide. After that, reduction zone. In this zone, spongy iron is formed and the temperature is around 875 Kelvin. The last zone is slag formation zone. It is the central zone and the temperature is around 1270 Kelvin. So first of all, the lowermost zone has temperature around 1800 Kelvin. Next zone, that is fusion zone, it has temperature around 1570 Kelvin. Third zone is reduction zone and it has 875 Kelvin, and the last one is slag formation zone, which has temperature around 1270 Kelvin. In this zone, calcium carbonate is broken down into calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. The calcium oxide formed combined with silicon oxide and form calcium silicon oxide. Sabse pehle, in combustion zone, carbon dioxide is formed, which goes up and convert into carbon monoxide. After that, in slag formation zone, calcium carbonate is converted into calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. The calcium oxide so formed combines with silicon oxide and formed calcium silicon oxide.